I'm not bad talking to people, but if the camera's on and I know it, I'll be like,
So what happened after you saw her on the stroller?
Saw a camera out of the
place? It just came to me. I was sitting in the Starbucks down south, and I drew a picture of her. Mm-hmm. It came out beautiful. I'm like, yeah, I like this. So I developed a very simple story, maybe about 4 or 5 pages worth. Because I had already seen the time she was in, some of the things that she would probably see or go through, because this is like a futuristic, about 2,000 years from now. Whenever the person reads it, it's about 2,000 years from now. So everything's changed. And it's her quest really to find me.
Nobody's as bad as Beyonce.
Because we never met, because of a certain situation, which I won't reveal. You know, that's just one of the good parts of the story.
Of course.
And it bounces off the story that I started in 2004.
She actually wrote many of the things.
It's just a lot of work. So this helps me simplify that right there. I got a stack of papers about this big, this wide. For a book that's probably going to be this big.
Oh, wow.
You know, so I have to go through all these pictures and see what I want to keep. A sketchbook for it, you know, people see like the process of it.
How did the story come to you?
You know, that's why I said what I said about being the last hurrah. So, you know what I'm saying? Because it feels like that. It feels like a sense of finality, like a new cycle. After a long cycle or some old stuff. But bits and pieces. When I was in Georgia, the things I was learning weren't the usual things you go to school for. There's no usual school for the things that I was learning. You know, it was very spiritual, esoteric. This person's system, their system, that culture, this culture, you know, all that. It just makes sense after that. Why certain things were falling into place. Why characters were showing up when they did.
Do you think we'll understand when we read it?
I think you'll come to... I think I want it to be one of those things where you read it once and you'll see it a certain way, but then you'll read it again and maybe... Because, you know... See, I was going to be nice and I was going to throw this at you without opening it, but I'm going to open it first and squeeze it.
Hey, I'm not the one cleaning
it. See, this is the thing that... Employees need to hear. But anyway.
Do you think we'll understand the story when we read it? When we read the book?
From a certain perspective. It depends on where you're at. I feel if you pick something up, you're meant for it. If you run into something, you're meant to see it. Blah, blah, blah. If nothing else, it's just for the heart.
So why are you doing this book? What's your drive for it?
I've done a lot for everybody else, for one. This I have full control of. I don't have to answer to anybody but myself, for one thing. But it means so much because of my grandmother, a lot of the experiences that I went through while this was being created were not the normal. So it's like stuff that sticks with me, you know what I mean? Keep myself out of trouble, I guess.
Are you proud of it?
Oh God, I love it. Like, I don't even care if I put it out. It's just something I want to do with my damn self first. Like, I'm not even concerned if anybody else is going to feel it. But a lot of people have been gravitating towards it, so... Hey, it is what it is. I mean, it's like that with anything. Music. You don't do it because you want everybody's approval of it. You do it because it's what changes you, kind of thing. Sometimes I don't know why I'm just doing it.
How long have you been working on it?
2010. I can say that easily. Because right after I did my first comic. Because I was sitting on my cousin's porch. They were supposed to be home, but they weren't, so I had to sit on the porch. And that's when I heard all the first time I heard the name in my head.
Are you going to share the name with us, or is it something private?
It'll be in there. You know, it's weird because it has a very... It bears on the very end of the book.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's a lot that I reveal that I already know that everybody doesn't... I've seen it a million times. It's a little bit redundant for me. So mm-hmm. sometimes I have to push through it. But for now, you just know her as Fancy. She has another name that's revealed later that ties in, and then you get the full scope of what really happened and why this journey is so important.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay. Makes it easier. She's half a fairy. She's from the fairy world.
Mm-hmm.
But she was conceived in the human world. Her mother was a fairy who came over to the human world. You know, just like initiation every month. But her father was, let's just say, this beautiful fairy, her mother, fell in love with the actual angel of death. So she's got both of these natures.
Mm-hmm.
She's never met her father, so she views that side of her as a curse.
Mm-hmm.
But it's the most powerful thing ever. It sets her apart from everything else. So her journey is she leaves the fairy world into the human world to find clues to where her father is, or at least a resting place. And she finds nothing but trouble and a whole world coming to get her, basically, you know, because of who she is. She doesn't know until she gets further up. But the basic premise is she's the heiress to two different kingdoms, and she doesn't even know because of her mother and her father. Her mother and her father is the interesting story, and that happens prior. That's what that other book is about. But it's like everything else. It's the basic journey of a hero story. Love story. Isis, Osiris, Neo, Trinity. You know, whoever you was like, whatever. You know what I mean? That's what that is. Classic.
That sounds beautiful. I can't wait for it to come out.
Very credible.
Save me my copy.